So now we recite the first sloka of Narayaniyam. Sandranandavabodhatmakam.
Sandranandavabodhatmakam.
Anupamitam kaladeshavadibhyam.
Anupamitam kaladeshavadibhyam.
Nirmuktam nityamuktam.
Nirmuktam nityamuktam.
Nigamashatasahasrena nirbhasyamanam.
Nigamashatasahasrena nirbhasyamanam.
Aspashtam drishtamatre.
Aspashtam drishtamatre.
Punarurupurushartatmakam.
Punarurupurushartatmakam.
Brahma-tattvam,
tattavad-bhāti-sākṣātu,
guru-pavana-pure-hanta-bhāgyam-janānām.
Guru-pavana-pure-hanta-bhāgyam-janānām.
So we are just talking about the Brahma Tattva, who is the Krishna Paramatma, is not simply Brahma, but whatever Tattva is there of Krishna, which is very hard for us to unravel, but we can only see the glimpses of the Tattvam, and therefore that Brahma Tattvam takes the concrete form and shining in the Guru Pavana Pura, and if they are trying to fulfill the entire Purusharthas, that is Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha, Purusharthas for human beings, and so that great God Krishna specialized in the aspect of Arogya, and he is being installed or established by Guru and Vayu, both of them, in order to protect the land and people for generations together, because the gods have got their placement upon the earth and they receive a lot of worship, and that is really beneficial for them and lucrative prosperity for the people upon the earth who are born or die, because the earth is taken as the Jagat. Jagat means there is nobody can remain constant on this world. All people are to come and go again. So these kind of things are there. But when all this come and go is over, then ultimately after a certain period, there will be the pralaya, a total annihilation, a great devastation. Then after hours, we have got more nature to come up, and ultimately the whole lokas and whole area will be filled with water. Over the water, Narayana will be resting upon the serpent bed, that is Adishesha Sayana, and he will also go to sleep, making that Kala Shakti to be wakeful. And when the entire process of pralayam is over, then the Kala Shakti is asked to wake him up. Then Narayana wakes up because of the Kala Shakti. When he's awakened, he just looks that the entire pralayam process is complete, and so he entrusted all the powers and knowledge to Brahma, who has come up from the Nabhi and at height, right? And Brahma was able to get all the knowledge and everything regarding the creation process and all that. Therefore, and moreover, the Brahma Deva has appeared over the divine Kamalam, Divya Kamalam, Divya Sarojam, and that Divya Sarojam over which a cozy seat that Brahma was sitting was having only 8 petals, Ashtadala, and in all the petals whatever creation, whatever knowledge, everything has been deposited or done in that, and Brahma was able to get. Now we are just trying to talk about the Srishti, Krama, and in the ninth dashakam we have noted how the Jagat has been Srishti, has been created, and in the tenth we have seen the variety in the creation, how Vedas, Puranas, then ultimately Parvavidyas, all of them has come into being. So then all that knowledge and everything is vested in Brahmadeva. And also his other four sons, like the rishis, Sanaka, Sanandana, Sanat Kumara, and they got the ability for enhancement of the creation. That's called Sarga Vruddhi. And so ultimately in the 10th dashakam, a prayer submitted that Govinda Marutapuradhipa Rundhirogan Tabhyam Manushakulani Vivardhayaha Tvam Sripum Sambhavam Aham Mahama Janmam Nuta Vadhubhyam Janan Upayam Atadeha Bhajo Deha Ajo Vibhajya. So he tried to divide himself and into the form of Sri and Pumsa, and he created the Manushakula and enhancement of the same. So Govinda is who will be comforting and presenting comfort, happiness to all people in the world, the whole nature. And he is installed in Marutapuradhisa. Rogan Rundhi. What is his main job? Rundhi, stop. Make a wall to all kinds of rogas, that they will not increase, they will be under control. Then when all these things happen, now we go to 11th dashaka, where there is a entry of the Maharshi Sanaka and Sanandana. They are not very magnanimous in look. They are very short and all that. So what happened in Vaikuntha, we are going to study now. Please repeat two times. Krameṇa sarge parivardhamāne.
Krameṇa sarge parivardhamāne. Krameṇa sarge parivardhamāne.
Kadāpi divyāḥ sanakādayaste.
Kadāpi divyāḥ sanakādayaste. Kadāpi divyāḥ sanakādayaste.
Bhavadvilokāya vaikuṇṭha vikuṇṭha lokam.
Bhavadvilokaya vikunthalokam. Bhavadvilokaya vikunthalokam.
Prapedire maruta mandiresha.
Prapedire maruta mandiresha. Prapedire maruta mandiresha.
Manognanaihi.
Manognanaihi. Manognanaihi.
अनोपमं तं भवतो निकेतम्.
Anupamam tam bhavato niketam. अनुपमं तं भवतो निकेतम्।
मुनीश्वराः प्रापुः
मुनीश्वराः प्रापुः मुनीश्वराः प्रापुः
अतीतकक्ष्याः
अतीत्यकक्ष्याः अतीत्यकक्ष्याः
भवद्दिदृक्षं भवनं विविक्षून्
भवद्दिदृक्षून् भवनं विविक्षून् भवद्दिदृक्षून् भवनं विविक्षून्
द्वास्थौ
त्वास्थौ त्वास्थौ
जयस्तान् विजयोऽप्यरुन्धाम्
जयस्तान् विजयोऽप्यरुन्धाम्
येषां च चित्ते पदमापकोपः
तेषां च चित्ते पदमापकोपः तेषां च चित्ते पदमापकोपः
सर्वं भवत्प्रेरणयैव भूमन्
सर्वं भवत्प्रेरण प्रेरणयैव भूमन् सर्वं भवत्
सो दिस् इस् अ वेरि सिम्पल् ब्यूटिफुल् स्टैल् एण्ड् दि संस्कृत हियर् इस् सो easy for us to understand, but to interpret and the depth in the slokas is large. In Bhagavatam original, we get the description of the Vaikuntham. Vaikuntha Varnana happens to be a wonderful episode in the Bhagavatam written by our Vyasa Bhagavan. But here, that kind of complicated details found in the Bhagavatam have been beautifully represented in small, in this short slokas, beautifully. Now look at it. Kramena sarge parivardhamane. So the sarga is the creation. Actually, what are the lakshana of maha, of puranas? A purana must have these characteristics essentially. Sargascha, pratisargascha, vamsho, मन्वन्तराणि च वंशानुचरितं चैव पुराणं पञ्चलक्षणम्. सो इफ् अट् आल् यु वाण्ट् टु टाक् अबौट् पुराण, इट् हेस् टु हेव् अ फैव् केरेक्टरिस्टिक्स्. सो सर्ग, प्रतिसर्ग एण्ड् सृष्टि, आल् दीस् थिङ्ग्स् मस्ट् बि देयर्. अकार्डिङ्ग्लि वी हेव् हियर् आल्सो द पायिण्ट्स् पिक्ड् अप् बै दि भट्टातिरि, who is that great author of this Narayaniyam, who was able to get the benefit of rid of his complaint, that is the leprosy he had, and he got rid of that. And again, there are so many other people who got their bodily, physical ailments and mental ailments being relieved from them because of the extra grace of that Guru Ayur Krishna. So now the process of creation is keeping on going on because Srishti, Sthiti and Pralaya. But now the Pralaya is over, the Srishti has taken repetition again because Brahmanda Mandalas, Leela Kalpita Brahmanda Mandala Yena Mo Namaha. So Leela Kalpita means it keeps on absorbed. And again, whatever is absorbed, again projected back. So this is a sport. You know, everybody must have something pastime. Our pastime, we know. But the children pastime, we know. Because they go to Toys R Us, Toys R Us, and Babies R Us. So in those companies, they go and buy so many things. But here, you see that the Sarga is keeping, especially soon after Pralaya, the creation process was in progress. Not only simply progress, but it is becoming more and more violent and virulent. When that kind of process was going on, the Maharshis, Sanaka, Sanandana, Sanat Kumara, that's why Sanakadayaha. What, who are the Sanakadayaha? Divyaha Raharshayaha. They are divine sages. See, we have got the Divya Sages, that is, they are all divine, almost God, they are near God. They are not God, but they are near God, maybe also above God. Because if you talk who is really important and famous between a Rishi and God, the answer goes to Rishi only. Because that's why Rishis are said to be always hard workers. When Dushyanta in Abhijnana Sakuntalam, as he visited the Kanva Ashrama, when he meets some Sishyas there, so he compliments them, Aho Kashta Tapase. So Tapasu is Kashta. So that is a very hard job to do. And that kind of hard job people are doing, and they have really become Divyaha. Divyaha, highly brilliant, highly luminant, highly powerful, highly potential, something not they are superior. So they, what is it, kadapi, sometime in a day, Sarakadi and other Maharshis, what did they do? Vaikuntha lokam bhavadvilokaya. They visited the Vaikuntha loka. Loka is a region, is a large area. And in that large area, what is it called as Vaikuntha? Vikuntha means break. Vikuntha means no break. So everything is round. Everything is perfect. Nothing different is there. That's why in that particular luxurious, comfortable, harmonious loka region, our Mahavishnu is dweller. He dwells there. And therefore, the Sarakadi Maharshis wanted to have a look at him, talk with him, and darshan of him. So Bhavadvilokaya, O Guruvayur Krishna, you are Mahavishnu. And so in order to look at you, they visited you there, and Prapedire Maruta Mandiresha. So O Maruta Mandiresha, Maruta Mandira is the temple. Mandira is the sacred pilgrim center. So Guruvayuru is a pilgrim center. Tirupati, Tirusanur or Tirumala religious center. Like that, it is called as Maruta Mandira, Venkatesha Mandira. Mandira is that. So they just visited. Prapedire means reached. So traveling long distance, they reached the Vaikuntha Loka. And what was that? And how? What did they observe? How was the Vaikuntha? In one sloka, the entire Vaibhava of the Vaikuntha has been described. Manogna nai shreyasa kananadyai. See, there are kananadyai. Kananas are the gardens. There are plentitude of forests and gardens which are delightful to the heart. Manogna. Manognanaihi means manaha jagna is janati. So manaha janati saundaryam. That is the beauty of the locations, number of gardens and all that is able to get attracted by the mind. You know, tongue attraction, mouth attraction and all those are superficial. But when your mind is really attached, that is a yoga. Actually, what is yoga? Yoga is to control your mind, control your manas, and make the manas a stable situation, and instill in the manas the great image of the Paramatma, and that is what we call meditation, and you will get the respective vibrations and responses when once your manognatva is being recognized. So Shreyasa Kananadyaihi. The word Shreyas is interesting, is a big concept in Alankara Shastra, in Vedanta Shastra. and other Shreyas is the most required penultimate qualification in order to get moksha. So Shreyaha Pasyati in the Kalidasa is not ordinary fellow. I'm quoting Kalidasa because he is one of the important poets who have done a lot of service and given that, especially for religious distinction. His three dramas pave a pathway. For example, his first drama is called as Malavika Agnimitra. There he says, Sanmargalokanaya Yapanayatu Vaha Tamasim Ruttimishaha. See, all people have got great percentage of the Tamoguna in them. Sattva, Raja and Tamas. So Tamas Guna make all people become more frightened, fearful, doubtful, and all that. In fact, Arjuna was gripped by the Tamas Guna more, that he is going to be a better sinner by killing all of his kith and kin, and he doesn't want to be a permanent resident of the Narkaloka, etc. Therefore, here that Sanmarga Lokana is one, and also next one is Shreyaha. So Nisreyasayaha Avatu Vaha Sasthanuhu Sasthanuhu, that Shiva is a sthanu. Sthanu means a pillar. Normally he will not budge. He is always constantly deep in the meditation. Dhyana yoga is there. So from that dhyana, he has to open the eyes and bless us. And what he should give? The necessary Shreyaha and the Lakshmikaram. And next one, when once you get that Sanmarga Lokana, then Shreya Prapti, and ultimately what you would be getting is Brahma Sakshatkara, Ashtamurti Sakshatkara. That is how the stepping stones have been laid by great poets. Because as it is, we don't know. We only aspire and desire. We don't deserve at all. Unless you work, you don't deserve. So we have to deserve and desire. But people are fond of desiring, but not deserving. Therefore, here you observe that the Mano, Gna and Shreyas, and all the Karanajayi, there are number of pleasure gardens. And not what is more there, Aneka Vapi Mani Mandira is cure. What are more there in Vaikuntha? There are a number of Vapi. Vapi means well, with water. So well, round shaped ones, oblong ones, and then square ones. All kinds of wells are there. And in the Vapi also you find number of lotuses. And there are also mandiras, that is buildings, studded with the gems. And on that too, gems which are of different colors. Aneka Varna, Navaratnas we call it, you know. Navaratna, Nirmata, Maha, Bhavanas are there in Vaikuntha. But in Kailasa, as you observed, there is no building at all. Ravana was the first and last Bhakta who thought that Shiva must have a comfortable building. But how could a Shiva afford? Because we cannot ask for anything with him. You don't want begging bowl, you don't want the Nagabharana, you don't want the Kapala Patra, you don't want to remain not combing your hair. In fact, Sivananda Lahari, tomorrow, you observe, Shiva is so ugly to look at because his hair has turned matted because he has no mother. If mother is there, takes care of the child and child will be dressed and beautified. But Shiva has no mother. So he just grows like that only. Anyway, so Shreyasa Karanadjaihi Aneka Vapi Mani Mandiraischa. Mandiras are the closed apartments where you can rest and hide and get comfort. So there are so many mandiras like that. And again, Anopamam Tam Bhavato Niketam. When he comes and looks at the palace of Mahavishnu Niketa, so Niketana is the palace, is the residential place. So Bhavato Niketanam Anupamam. Anupam means incomparable. You cannot at all have any comparison. In other words, it is called as a Ananvayalankara. Ananvayalankara means you cannot have any comparison but how like the Alankara Shastra tells you that Gaganam Gaganakaram Sagaraha Sagaropamam Ramaravanayor Yuddham Ramaravanayoriva. How is the sky? It is like sky only. Gaganam Gaganakaram. How is the ocean? It is like the ocean only, no comparison. And how was the battle between Rama and Ravana? It was like the battle between Rama and Ravana. So this Aranvayatva is a characteristic of the supremacy there. Therefore, it is called Anupamam. You know, Upamana, Upameya, Sadharana Dharma. Well, these are all the components of Upamalankara are similar. But when he says that Anupamam, there is no second comparable building or palace that of Mahavishnu. It is a luxurious apartment that has got Bhavato Niketam. Your building, your palace is incomparably beautiful. And so, Muniswaraha Prapu Atita Kachyaha. Then these Muniswaraha Saraka Sarandana, they somehow reached the palace of Mahavishnu, and which contained a number of rooms. Kachyaha. Kachya is the room. And there are so many rooms. And he went to see Saptadvaram. That's why Kavata Patanakari, Kasipuradhiswari. So there are many, many doors for the residents or of great, great rich people. Therefore, these Muniswaras, they try to cross over one after the other, the Kachyaha or the rooms, and then in order to find, they almost came up to the door place of the residence or room of Narayana inside. So there were two doorkeepers, Jaya and Vijaya, and they were not at all, unless they permit, nobody can have interview with them. That's why here you see that the two doorkeepers were there. And when why did they go to Vaikuntha Loka? Why did they go to Vikuntha Loka? It is just the simple task. Bhavad Didrukshu, they wanted to have a look at you, Mahavishnu. They wanted to find out how you are like. And Bhavanam Vivatshun. So they were all keeping on examining the building. And they found the Bhavanam of Mahavishnu, the palace of Mahavishnu, so enchanting. So much beautiful. But Jaya and Vijaya were the Dva Sthav. Dva is the Dwaram. Sthav means the doorkeepers. So Jaya Vijayas are the two doorkeepers who were to permit anybody to enter and have interview with the God. They are called otherwise Pujar. We have a Telugu saying, Devudu Varaminchina Pujari Varamivudu. పూజారి వరం ఇచ్చేస్తే దేవుళ్ళు ఆటోమేటిక్గా ఒబ్లైజ్ చేస్తారు. దేర్ ఫోర్ అండ్ ఆల్సో ఇఫ్ యూఆర్ ది చీఫ్ మినిస్టర్ కార్ డ్రైవర్ ఇస్ యువర్ ఫ్రెండ్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఈజీ టు మీట్ ద చీఫ్ మినిస్టర్ ఎనీ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ టైమ్స్. సో లైక్ దాట్ హియర్ ఆల్సో అది జయ విజయ హావ్ గాట్ టు పర్మిట్ దెమ్ టు గో ఇన్సైడ్ అండ్ హ్యావ్ ఇంటర్వ్యూ అండ్ దర్శన్ ఆఫ్ నారాయణ. సో వే ఆర్ దేర్, they are there at the door. Dvaha Sthav. Dvaha means Dwaram, the gate, the door. And Tan Api Arundhan. So when Sarakasarandanas came, they tried to obstruct these two sages to to enter inside the palace and then have darshan, because they were the guardians and of the palace and doorkeepers. Because unless doorkeepers permit, you cannot see the master like that. And tesham chachitte padamapagopaha. So api arundhatam. Actually, they don't know. The Jayavijaya school fellows, they cannot admit everybody inside the big people. So they objected. And then these maharshis became little disturbed. When we come, how is that Narayana is not giving us interview? So Bhavadritru, Bhavadritru Chun, Bhavanam Vivichun, Dvasto Jayaha, Vijayaha, Tanapi Avarundham. So they went on observing the beauty of Vaikuntha Loka, a number of wells, a number of pleasure gardens, a number of beautiful things, and Navaratna Kachita doors. All this is a part of description of the Vaikuntha. Very sometimes, you know, in America people come and say, hey, your house looks like a Vaikuntham. And that's what the luxury. But this much luxury you can't afford in India ordinarily. And the Indian styles are different. So here you observe Tesham last night. Tesham chachitte padamapakopaha. See, when this Jayavijayas stopped the rishis and denying the entry into the palace, then what is that? Actually, rishis are quite calm, pleasant, attractive, and magnificent in looks and karna. But in this case, when they are denied of their admittance to meet Narayana directly, then they became kopa, angry. See, kopa padamapa chitte. You should observe the language and how it has been styled. See, kopam is a separate compartment. You know that Maharajas will have separately a kopa gruha. Whenever people are angry, they are not supposed to stay in their bedrooms. They should go and stay in the Kopagruha. If the Arthaharas, if the reporters go and tell Maharaja that so-and-so is in the angry, something like Kaikeyi, who was in the Kopagruha. So what these people, they just got anger, not outside, deep inside their mind. So Chitta is supposed to be the seat for all emotions, all gods, and all everything. That's why kama, krodha, lobha, moha, mada, matsarya, all these emotions are stocked in that particular place. But if you are making them pleasant, naturally the whole patavanam will be pleasant. So tesham chachitte kopaha padamavapa. Actually, padam means placement. The anger took seat in the building or in the mind of Durvasa Maharshi. And sarvam bhavat prerana eva bhuman. Aya mahanubhava, bhuman means aishwaryavan. Oh, rich you, God, Krishna. Because ashtabharyas are there. All of them are really significant and powerful to enhance the power of Krishna. Therefore, bhavat prerana yaiva bhuman. O bhuman, bhuman means dhana yuktaha janaha. Those who have got plenty of things, they are called bhumans. I hope you understood prerana. Prerana is impulsion. What has to happen shall happen because of the directive unknown to us but given to the doers. That's what is called as that. Now, bhavat prerana, prerana is urging them. And one compliment for this Guruvayur Krishna is bhuman. Bhuman means aishwarya yuktaha, aishwaryavan ityarthaha. Now I think you understood all this. So Amma, in Paramatma, all this that has taken place, that is going to take place, is only due to your impulsion, due to your prerana. So, and moreover, it's a compliment to him, Bhuman. So samsara is one and Vaikuntha is another. But in order to make use of these two locations, there is the grace of Vishnu much needed, because he is the owner general of the whole property. Now repeat. Vaikuntha lokanu Vaikuntha lokanuchita.
Vaikuntha lokanuchita. Vaikuntha lokanuchita.
Prachestau.
Prachestau.
Kastau yuvam daitya gatim bhajetam.
Kastau yuvam daitya gatim bhajetam. Kastau yuvam daitya gatim bhajetam.
Iti prasastau bhavadasritau. Tau.
Iti prasastau bhavadasritau. Tau. Iti prasastau bhavadasritau. Tau.
Harismrutihi.
Harismrutihi. Harismrutihi.
No astviti.
No astviti. No astviti.
Nematu hutan.
Nematu hutan. Nematu hutan.
Tadetadagnaya. Tadetadagnaya.
Tadetadagnaya. Tadetadagnaya.
Bhavanavaptaha. Bhavanavaptaha.
Bhavanavaptaha. Bhavanavaptaha.
Sahaiva lakshmiya bahirambhujaksha.
Sahaiva lakshmiya bahirambhujaksha. Sahaiva lakshmiya bahirambhujaksha.
Kaghe kageswara samsarpita charu bahu.
Kageswaram sarvita charu bahu. Kageswaram sarvita charu bahu.
Anandayam stan.
Anandayam stan. Anandayam stan.
Abhirama murtya.
Abhirama murtya. Abhirama murtya.
Prasadya girbhistuvato munindra.
Prasadya girbhistuvato munindra. Prasadya girbhistuvato munindra.
Nananyanatha vatha parshadautau.
Nananyamanatha vatha parshadautau. Ananyanatha vatha parshadautau.
Samrambhayogena.
Samrambhayogena. Samrambhayogena.
Bhavastribhirmam.
Bhavastribhirmam. Bhavastribhirmam.
Upa upata mamupeta mityatta krupam.
Mamupeta mityatta krupam. Mam upeta mityapta krupam.
Nyagadihi.
Nyagadihi. Nyagadihi.
Tvadiya bhrutyavatha kasyapattau.
Tvadiya bhrutyavatha kasyapattau. Tvadiya bhrutyavatha kasyapattau.
Surarivira uditau.
Surarivira uditau. Surarivira uditau.
Ditau dvau.
Ditau dvau. Ditau dvau.
Sandhya samutpadana kashta cheshto.
Sandhya samutpadana kashta cheshto. Sandhya samutpadana kashta cheshto.
Yamaucha lokasya.
यमौ
यमाविवान्यौ
च यमाविवान्यौ
सो अगेन वी हैव गॉट अ ब्यूटिफुल श्लोकास सो व्हेन द जय सी व्हेन वैकुंठ लोका अनुचित प्रचेष्टौ कष्टौ युवाम दैत्यगतिम भजेताम सो व्हेन दे वर अब्स्ट्रक्टेड एंट्री बाय जय विजयास देन इमीडिएटली दे बिकेम एंग्री यू सी कोपहा पदमापा कोपम वाज देयर एंड दैट हैज टेकन रूट इन देम And then they cursed the Jayavijayas. And what saying what? Vaikuntha lokanuchita prachishtau. Your chesta, your behavior, your character and conduct is not conforming to the dignity, serenity of the location Vaikuntha, and you have been appointed as the gods just before the Vishnu, therefore you have given me a great kashta. So, chesta, kashta, ishta, very interesting words. So, yuvam daityagatim bhajetam. The curse was that you become daityas or danavas or rakshasas. And iti prasastau bhavada sritau tau. So like that they cursed the Jayavijayas and then knowing all that Mahavishnu comes up to meet the sages. See, look here, Vaikuntha loka anuchita prachestau kashtau ivam daityagatim bhajetam. So Daitya Gati is taking the birth of a Rakshasa. Or you know that Kashyapa Prajapati has got two wives, Diti and Aditi. And those children born to Aditi, they're all known as Adityaha, that means gods. Those who are born to Diti, they are called Daityaha. So right from the cradle, the Duryodhana and Dharmaraja, rather Pandavas and Kauravas were in dagger heads. They were all fighting. So here you observe Vaikuntha Lokanuchita Pracheshtau Kashtau Yuvam Daityagatim Bhajetam. So they say you become Daityas, not deserving any fruit. That's why he says that Vaikuntha Loka Anuchita Chesta. The chesta which the two doorkeepers performed is not appropriate or proper for the residents of Swargaloka. He has made a wonderful mistake. For that, no kind of blessing to him. And again, iti prasastau bhavada asritau tau. So when this kind of leisure or condition has been taken and mentioned, then what? Bhaktas did, they just Vaikuntha Loka Anuchita Pracheshtau Kashtau. So they performed the rituals. Because you know that on 13th day you go and call people, all people, general public and all that, with a plea that it's a Vaikuntha Divasa or Vaikuntha Divasa Samaradhana. It's a form of worship. Done then like that. Here you see that prasastau daityagatim bhajetam. You just be born as rakshasas. And bhavadasritau tau hari smriti naha astu iti nematuhu tan. So this is a bhakti sloka where instruction has been given to these Sanaka Sanandanas that they should be given such state. They are all Daitya Putras or Diti Putras, and therefore, accordingly, they shall, these two must become Rakshasas. Hiranyaksha, Hiranyakasapa, Ravana, Kumbhakarna. And like that, we have got Kamsa and Dantavaktra. Well, these are all the great enemies of Narayana. Getting killed by them in battle, they added prosperity. One don't know. Prosperity for the Daityas, and so Harismrutihi naha astriti nematuhu nematustan is prasastav. So because you are Vishnu, there may be Hari Dvesha there. And now, looking all that going on at the door, Mahavishnu with his consort Lakshmi, they come out to receive the sages. We have also noted that a sage is superior compared to the gods. So, tadetad agnaya bhavana vaptaha sahaiva lakshmiya bahir ambujaksha. He ambujaksha, O lotus-eyed Narayana, you came out along with Lakshmi when once you know what is going on at your door. So you just came, and while coming, how did you come? Kageswaro Kageswarom sarpita charubahu. He has kept his hands, rested his hands on the back of the Garuda. So here the wording is that Khageshwara is Garuda, Khaga is bird, because it's called Khaga because Ke Gacchati iti Karmanaha Khagaha. So a Khaga is that it is able to fly in the air with good speed. And we are all familiar with the term Vimanam. Why it is called Vimana, Vigraha Vakya tells you. Viyati minoti iti vimana. It measures distances in the sky. So it is called vimanam. So it's all a manam, the measuring rod. Yes, here in this sloka, that sahaiva lakshmiya khageswara amsa arpita charu bahu. Amsa is the shoulder. So over the shoulder portion of the Garuda, he just put his hand, and Charubahu, who has got a beautiful bahu or shoulders, and Anandayantan Abhirama Murtya. When Vishnu himself with his Lakshmi comes out to greet the rishis, and the rishis felt extremely happy. See, Anandayantan Abhirama Murtya. How was the Murti or figure of Vishnu? It was very much Abhirama. It was so beautiful that they wanted to watch on. See, you know that Punyam Punyas Punya Pumsam Mohara Rupaya Punyaslokaya Mangalam. We make a prayer to Venkatramana. Balaji, who is that fellow? Pumsam Mohana Rupaya. He has such a beautiful personality that even men get attracted to him. Indeed, so. So, Punya Slokaya Mangalam. And Mangalam for the Punya Sloka. Here also, you observe Kageswara Samsarpita Charu Bahu. His hand, his Bahu shoulders, he is so perfect and beautiful and handsome. Quite conforming to the Lakshana Savi Bahu, and Khageswara Samsara Charu Bahu, and Anandayam Stan Abhirama Murtya. So Prabhasaganas, whoever accompanied them, these rishis have made them pleased. And so Khageshwaramsa Arpita Charubahu. So Charubahus are very much convenient and precious. And so Khageshwara Asarpita. Asarpita means up crawling. Asarpita Charubahu. Anandayantan Abhirama Murtya. So Abhir, how was your personality when you are observing this beauty? It was Abhirama. You were quite handsome. You decorated yourself with all ornaments and somehow you made yourself appear as the most powerful ruler of the land at that time. Therefore, and for here the poet suggests that Ananda is important, and then next one is that Bhakti is important, and Mahavishnu would like his Shishyas, his Bhaktas, so he would visit to greet them along with his Kamsa, Lakshmi Devi, and so on. Now in the sixth sloka, we are able to see Prasad Jagir Bhihi Stubato Munindra Nananya Natha Nathatha Nathavatha Parshada Utau Sambrambha Yogena Bhavastri Bhirmam Upetam Iti Atta Krupam Nyagadi. So they cursed that Jayavijayas, but now there is a kind of parihara to get rid of the curse and become normal devotees and sages. So they cannot kill sages, but they will meet them to learn the lessons. So Prasad. So Prasad Jagir Bhihi Stuvato Munindra. So with Gir Bhihi, with the speech, with the stotras, they are all praising Mahavishnu. And what is the Munindras doing? Stuvataha Ananyanatha Patha Parshadautau. Ananyanatha means there cannot be better leader than Guruvayur Krishna or Mahavishnu only. And so said Ananyanatha. Then, and who are they? They are called Parshada Devatas. Parshadas are primary gods who controlled all these things. So Anandayanta Abhimu. And the sixth sloka, you are seeing Prasadya Girbhi Stuvato Munindraha. Please repeat. Prasadya Girbhi.
Prasadya Girbhi. Prasadya Girbhi.
Stuvato Munindraha.
Stuvato Munindraha. Stuvato Munindraha.
Nanyanathavatha Parshadau Tau.
Nanyanathavatha Parshadau Tau. Nanyanathavatha Parshadau Tau.
Sambrambha Yogena.
Sambrambha Yogena. Sambrambha Yogena.
Sambrambha Upetam Iti, Upetam Iti Atta Krupam Nyagadihi. So there is a instruction given to the rishis, Sambrambha Yoga, and only three of you perform. Later on you come to me, I will give more and more gifts to you. That is the indication of Guruvayur Krishna, and this is the Vaikuntha Vaibhava with all the available material in the fahi, in that place. Therefore, here you see Upeta Mityattam Nigadi. So today we stop here and we continue next day, next class. But because the Narayanam is a very powerful text which has got that Tantra Mantra effect. So every sloka is Jhana sloka, every mantra is a formula. So definitely we will be able to accomplish whatever we want, because that's why we always say Krishna Sahaya. With the help of the Krishna Sahaya, things will be all right, perfect. So Om Sarvam Sri Krishna Arpanamastu.